Yeah. What's going on, nigga? Oh. Really love these boys, nigga. Cat. Yeah. Yeah.
Don't make me slide. Pull up on one of the guys, and I'm hoping he won't be surprised. When I pull up the one on his side, don't make me slide. And I'm hoping I catch him on lock. And it's only a matter of time. This bro to be out of his mind. Don't make me slide.
Yo, welcome back. Return of the Mac, M.A.C., Moss, Andrew, Carl. Episode 148 back in the building again.
Yeah.
We're back. Memorial Day?
Yes.
That's what it is. That's what it is.
Happy Memorial Day. We're doing this on Memorial Day. We're a little bit late. Had a busy weekends.
Yeah. People said it?
What?
Happy Memorial Day?
I don't know.
I don't think I've ever heard that.
I don't know.
It's one of them. That's probably not. I think this is probably the one where they get mad at you for saying that.
I just know after, like,
today, like, all the veterans or something like that.
Yeah.
Like a veteran.
I mean,
then they have a Veterans Day.
Yeah. That one, I think maybe that's the one in September.
Probably.
I don't know.
Again, I only know it because it's like the day that, like, after today, all the pools are open.
Yeah. Yeah,
I guess
that's really the landmark.
It's when the summer starts.
Right. For me, it's like, okay, summer now.
We're off of work though. We appreciate the people that died. Yeah. I think that's what Memorial Day is for.
Yeah,
okay.
Shout out to y'all because I'm not a military person, and I need y'all.
Oh, for sure.
Need y'all to be there so I don't have to.
That's a fact.
So they don't draft me.
Exactly.
My biggest thing is, like, I'll fight, but I'm not cutting my hair though.
That's fair.
That's fair. Insane.
I don't think you get like to pick what you want to do or not. I think if you win it.
Look, I'm offering.
I'm going to use my veto on these.
If you go in, the hair is getting chopped, son.
That's what I want to know. Which one of y'all brave enough to try?
I'm fighting
and that beard.
Side.
You got to check that beard too. There ain't no beard in the military.
We can compromise slightly with the beard.
Carl going to end up fighting for the other side. He's like, I'm not cutting my hair. I guess I'm against y'all.
This is what you've earned. At that point, fuck it. Is what it is.
I just did.
Well, did y'all do anything this weekend with this long Memorial Day weekend? It's usually good barbecue time and stuff.
I didn't do too much over the weekend. I was chilling. Went to a good old 8th grade graduation on Friday, though.
You know? Yeah, we talked about that.
Oh, yeah.
They have a whole graduation.
They got to stop that shit immediately.
So I was thinking more like what you were thinking of. When you asked if we had a graduation when we were younger.
Right.
I remember having like an assembly thing that giving out awards for the smartest kids in the class and all that. But that was what
we
remember.
Perfect attendance.
We missed those days. Right. Yeah, all that shit. Attendance.
You're
and
saying
all that.
They did like robes and everything?
Well, like they didn't have robes. It was like a real like low level of a graduation. I don't even think they was calling it a graduation. My daughter was calling it a graduation and I was trying to correct her. I'm like, it's probably just a big assembly or something. And she was like, no, it's like, but they sent back the little flyers or whatever. It's like a celebration of the 8th grade.
Okay.
That's fine. I'm cool. Fine with that.
But they was doing it like a graduation though. Like it was in like, they had the band over there. They had the whole thing like it was a graduation. They walked in the lines.
You think they're being too soft on these kids? Like, yeah, you didn't do nothing. All you did was graduate 8th grade.
A little bit.
Yeah, I feel you.
It's on some like, yeah, like you can celebrate them. Whoever did well this year, who had the guy honor roll and all that, that's great.
But fuck them.
But the whole like fake diploma thing, they gave them little certificates, little colorful certificates. Mm. Like, this is childish. this is childish that y'all doing right now.
I just hate
you. Do not get no credit for finishing middle school. Well, you don't get anything for that.
I hate that we give people credit for all of the shit that they like, or even like kids, like we're starting to coach that, like, giving them credit for shit they're supposed to be doing. Right. And it's like, you always gonna grow up with this like entitlement.
This is awesome.
Like, I hate that shit, bro.
I'm not a fan of the like, yeah, the, what is it? Not the honorary awards, but what is it? The participation awards.
Right.
Like, just because, you pass every grade, it's like you get the last 7 grades.
What the fuck? I mean, look, congratulations, I guess, but that's just, if you don't make it, you fucking stupid. Like, that's just, that's the opposite. It's not like you fall in second place.
You don't make it, you fucking stupid. I don't
disagree.
I mean,
that's what I'm saying. I don't know. I hate that shit. And like,
getting held back. You're not ready yet.
Way too soft. Like at fucking field day for my daughter when they had field day the other week.
Talk to them. How old are these kids?
She's in first grade, so she's 7.
Tell them how they're babying these fucking first graders.
Y'all gonna have a graduation too, 5th grade graduation. They got those now too.
We probably won't participate.
No, she gonna want to be there, bro. You're not gonna skip her graduation. We might she gonna be there.
My dad said these are stupid, so we're not coming.
You can try positive. To fight against it. No, you got to be there. They want to be there.
But no, so we're doing field day or whatever. And, you know, they're competing. They're doing a bunch of different events, like relay race type things or whatever.
Yeah.
But then I just realized that.
Carlstein lost. That's why he's so
no,
mad.
No. I realized, like, nobody's actually taking score of anything.
What the fuck?
The kids are just out here running the fuck around.
It was recess.
Pretty much organized.
Organized recess. And, organized, you know, recess.
Every class is saying, like, oh, we won. Yeah.
Your it's voice, like, is wild right now. You're doing like a kid's voice with that defense.
Yo, I can't.
Oh, yeah.
We won. Yeah. And it's like, y'all came in last fucking place.
All these teachers are out there. Like, yo, this is the last day we've got to survive with all these little gremlins. Well, they're just out here trying to get energy out of these kids. And facts. Carl's like, why aren't they running this like a fucking combine? No. who's keeping
the 40 time?
No shit.
That girl was obviously slow. What'd she run?
No shit. I was low key out there scouting a little bit. I'm like, yo, this dude clearly plays soccer.
You should not tell people you're scouting out there.
Oh, what not? Scouting. You always want to make it weird.
Social experiment, bro.
Yeah, there you go.
Use the social experiment.
Yeah, I was like, yo, this is. Now you can see who's clearly an athlete and who's not, you know.
Yeah.
You know, this kid doesn't have a chance. You know, we already want to sign him up for, like, fucking karate or something. It's not going to be.
So you're just looking for the best of the best, or were you, like, looking for the diamond in the rough? That's when a real scout.
I mean, like, I guess, but you can spend your time on that if you want to. I'm not.
That's where the money is made. Everybody knows when the good kid's a good kid. You got to find where the bad kid's actually the good kid.
Oh, hey, I'm not into that.
Hey, I'm trying to put you on game right now.
Yeah, I'm not into that.
Hey, it is what it is, bro.
What was your social experiment, though? You told group, you were like, yeah. I went to this 8th grade graduation. It was kind of a social experiment. What were you testing?
I mean, I didn't go into it looking at these type of things, but it's some things that's just so obvious that you just have to pay attention to it. Okay. First of all, now, I wish it was like the whole school. I could get a better landscape of like the kids is in there, but this is just the 8th grade. About 90% blacks are the majority of the 8th grade class. About 90%. Whites are probably like 5%, and then you got the mix of Asians and Indians is like the other 5%.
What school does he go to?
Sandusky.
Is that really black kids?
They are the majority of the 8th grade class. Oh, fact. Big facts. I was like, oh, we up. Oh, we up now. So things are changing. Then they start getting to the awards. Bro, it was like, it was just so many black kids, you couldn't really see the whites in the midst of it. But every award come out, another white person will pop out the group. White person, I'm like, we not up again. This is not how it's supposed to be going.
White boys summer.
They getting all the awards, and it's like 90% black kids.
White boys summer.
I guess they have, like,
y'all got to step this shit up, bro.
They announce MVPs for the athletic teams.
When they start announcing the physical education awards, who got A's in that? All the athletes is up in that shit. I was like, okay, shit still got to change around a little bit.
This is just
still wild how we still like not winning none of these academic
awards. I will say this. I went to Heritage's graduation yesterday. My niece graduated from high school. A real graduation I went to yesterday.
Right.
And they're valedictorian or whatever. This chick's going to Stanford. She's a black chick. Black
That's
girl.
What's up. That's what's up.
Going to Stanford, and she got like 19 state records in track. It's just crazy.
Stanford's kind of like,
trying
to go to a real school.
I've never met anybody who actually went to Stanford, so I'm like, okay, that's
weak. Where the whites going?
Where the whites going?
Yeah, right.
MIT, bitch.
Oh, but yeah, finish your story.
I mean, yeah, that was pretty much it, though. Like, it went through it. It was kind of quick. They had no, like, extra shit going on. They stopped for, like, a second, had the band play, which to me, it was kind of late. She in the band. She was supposed to be performing. I don't know what happened. We was a little late for that. But anyway, it was cool. They went back, gave the awards, and then it was just over. They had, like, cake at the end. I'm like, all right, we're out of here.
Yeah.
It was white boys or white girls?
Both. Mm. Both. It was one white, big white boy. That motherfucker was smart as a motherfucker. He had all the awards.
Let's go, Colin.
I think he had the best GPA. He might have been like the valedictorian of the 8th grade class.
Don't put it in quotes.
He was racking it up. But they didn't call it like a valedictorian. That's another thing that was wild. They called some other Greek name. It was like Sigmoan or some wild Greek name. Well, it wasn't a valedictorian. I was like, oh, y'all really just trying to just make a little knockoff graduation right now. But it's whatever. Hey, shout out to them.
Trying to make it
got
up.
Got their awards. Let's hope their business.
High school don't fuck my young man up. You got a bright future right now.
Colin's going to be real. All right.
Yeah, he might be okay.
So that was my little mini social experiment. It was kind of, you know, I was seeing what's going on out here in the demographic.
He was hyping
the demographic of the middle school.
We up.
Here, though. This is crazy.
And it made me think, like, all right, so where are all the white kids? All white kids must be all in private schools now. They must be moving them out.
I don't know.
They all in LCA, Holy Cross, VES.
I don't know.
They must be all out because it was kind of dominant up in that joint.
I mean, it surprised me a little bit. They might be all in the county.
Maybe so.
There's plenty of them at Lilly School, I'll tell you that.
Facts. Rustburg. Swap. Area, yeah.
Half and half deep. Or something.
It's a swap.
I pledge.
Good shit.
Yeah, I guess.
It was all good, though. You know.
Good shit. Good social experiments. I'm going to start running social experiments and reporting back to the
public. Little people watching. It's kind of like low-key people watching.
Respect it.
Had a good
at the airport, right?
I do. Yeah. I hadn't taken like demographics and stuff, but I like to watch them.
Yeah, you got like to watch what's going on.
The weirdos. See, that's why you got to get the shades. You know, because you can look around and motherfuckers don't know.
Stare right at them.
Nah, I was at a bird's eye view. You know, you get the top of the bleachers against the wall where you can just see the whole gym. Yeah.
Nighthawk over here.
I can see everything. Before. I can see everybody in here. Yeah. It's an art to it, bro. Experience. It's an art to it.
You give you a game.
You got to be able to see everything that's going on out here.
Right.
That's all it is.
I forgot you had field day. That was this past Friday?
No, I mean, I feel like that shit was a couple weeks ago now. Maybe I didn't break it up last week or something. But
maybe not.
We were out there, man. It was a lot more parents out there than I expected.
Did that piss you off, too?
Participation is at a fucking high at her school, I'll tell you. Well, ain't no lacking for that shit on a field trip for chaperones. It was fun, though, man. It was cool. Met some of our classmates and stuff. They're a cool little group of kids. But it just really pissed me off they won't keep a score because I'm like, I want my fucking team to win, you know? We here to fucking win.
No,
I gave them a little game speech before it started, you know?
It's pretty soft, though. I had to agree with you, though. Because that's how you build character. Competition. Competition builds character.
Or just understanding that losing is okay.
Yeah.
And understanding that, okay, I have to lose sometimes. I can't be the fucking winner. Hey, you're not a spoiled fucking brat and this isn't your world. That's what the understanding part is. It's just like, okay, it's fine
for we all lose. Deserve this.
May I get
doing
another
the same.
Opportunity next time to win again.
I think first grade?
I think as immediately that should start.
I don't really think
all of that shit should start immediately. Fucking sharing like that, just type of behavior thinking. I feel like it gets wired. And think about like I always say, like with little kids and shit, or like toddlers and stuff like that. They don't really know much of anything. So anything that you tell them, it fucking sticks.
Right.
There's nothing in there. So they fucking just they're gonna remember that because they have no memories prior to it. You know what I'm saying? So I feel like these are like developmental, base level fucking, I don't know, like just principles that you could just wire into people. And if you, you know, teach them that kind of behavior early on, I feel like it sticks with them for the majority of their life until maybe they become old enough to understand the difference.
Yeah. It's like the video games. They got unlimited lives now. We come from a time where you had us like 4 or 5 lives. And you died, you had to restart the whole shit over
right.
again.
You pissed the fuck off.
Like it was an actual,
I got 2 lives left.
Actual consequence to losing.
That's true too. I didn't think about that.
You know what I'm saying?
That's a good comparison.
That is a good point.
It's crazy.
Like that.
It's crazy.
Now, I don't know. I feel you. I mean, I think you're right and stuff. And I, like at home, if I was at home playing games with the kids or something like that, that would be something I would want them to know. Relatively early. I'm thinking out on like a field day with a whole gang of first graders. Like, it's just like anything we can do to keep these kids from running all over the place. Like, just let them play.
I get that.
I think I probably wouldn't keep too many.
Schools. Also sounds lazy as well, too. I mean, I don't get it. I don't know. It's just like, hey, who cares about, you know, so-and-so's feelings getting hurt. That's what I like. See, who gives a fuck about that?
Yeah,
like,
in the crib is a different story. Whenever, you know, she called me out to play the FIFA. I'm gonna play you like you. We were playing somebody, anybody regular.
You gonna get beat.
I'm gonna dog you in this FIFA. You gotta get better.
Anything.
You gotta get better.
I'm like, I'm telling you,
it's going down.
I'm gonna be crushing Carter in basketball until I'm like fucking 50. Dog, you're not gonna fucking beat me. I'm not. It ain't gonna be no gimmies. I'm smacking that shit the fuck up out of here. You better find a way.
You gonna have to get nice.
Find a way around this shit.
And what to me do? She went got FIFA on her Nintendo, whatever it's called. Game Boy, not a Game Boy. SD.
He sounds so old.
Yeah, I do say old right there. Whatever. She went and got the FIFA on that. Now she got the FIFA on that. Getting it in. Yeah. I'm like, yeah, the game.
Been a Game Boy in years.
The Game Boy.
Fucking 20 years. SD Joe,
whatever it's called, bro.
Last Game Boy was released.
Wait, she got the FIFA on that. Now she trying to get it in.
I had one of those.
They were solid.
Yeah, that was it.
Game Boy was incredible.
If you had the Game Boy and then you got the Game Boy Color.
Then you get the Color.
That was it, bro.
That was like a little bit smaller. It was like, oh, yeah.
My sister left her
bulky. That original Game Boy was stupid bulky.
Stupid.
That shit was stupid bulky.
That shit looked like one of the T83 calculators or something.
Bigger.
A little bigger.
I remember I had like the little amplifier connection on it. It was like a magnifying screen I could put on it. I had one of them. That shit was so ridiculous. It was so ridiculous. Of a game.
Look, before cell phones were made, Game Boy might have been the greatest creation of all time.
Facts.
For parents and for kids.
Oh, for sure.
It's a lifesaver. We'd go on trips or something, and you just sit in the back seat.
Oh, tablets are such a bad thing. It's like, you had a fucking Game Boy. Shut the fuck up.
Same general idea.
Right.
Same general
idea. It's the same shit that your parents do, so you shut the fuck up for the next hour. Yeah,
exactly. Just less battery life.
Yeah, that's it.
What did y'all play?
I was playing Super Mario.
Mario was huge.
Donkey Kong, of course.
Donkey Kong. I played Ken Griffey Baseball and Madden. It's like Madden 98
games on there.
Madden 98 or some shit.
I'm trying to think of all the shits I had. It was
baseball
though
was my favorite.
It was mad games though.
I'm pretty sure I had some Pokemon games.
Yeah, definitely had that. Kirby, I had.
Yeah.
That was random. Don't know why that popped into my head. Yeah, good shit.
No backs,
Game Boy. I remember fire.
You being there. Could you use like some of the Game Boy games on the Game Boy Color, but not all of them?
Something like that. Yeah, I can't remember. Yeah. I can't remember what it was. Right. It wasn't over there cross pollinating.
No, you got to buy a whole new games now.
Yeah.
Got to make that turnover.
That's how it goes.
Oh, man. Good times. Those were the good old days.
Good times.
Those were good times.
Yeah, I got to find me a Game Boy. I'm going to order one.
I looked at it one time.
Really?
Yeah. I was like, yeah, this will be kind of tight. I don't remember if it was that I couldn't find something.
Gravity would kill you. It's great. It's moving all slow.
I think it would be
like limited motion and like movement and shit. It'd probably frustrate the fuck out of you.
Maybe. I think it would still be kind of fire to have. But it's whatever.
Maybe.
Anything else from this weekend?
No, it was good. You have anything on
them? Nah, I've been very much chilling this weekend.
Big chiller.
Nothing going on this week,
I'm
really.
Like a member of Blink 182 up in here, hair getting long.
So somebody, I went to poker last week and I had on all black and they were like, oh, now he's an emo kid.
You can really get
My
emo vibes. Go ahead and paint your nails black, bro. I'm going to go all out
MGK. Nah, this shit is getting long though. I was fucking around the other day with like some hair product and like slicked it back. It's long enough now that it will go.
You doing a Pat Riley?
It was kind of Pat Riley. Yeah.
They like white boy hair the way they jealous. Shout out to Wiz. That's a tough bar.
I like that. That's a good bar.
That's fine. You'll get the man bun going? Is that what you're going for?
One day.
Man bun life.
I'm being wild. One day.
That's going to be wild. You come in here.
Yeah, then I'm going to get locks.
Lock it up.
For sure. What's the Kodak joint?
Wix.
Wix, yeah.
Ooh, if you come in with the Wix, that would be wild.
Your shit will never survive. White people say it cannot wick. That shit is impossible.
Wait. Just wait. Don't believe me. Just watch. Hey. Trim that, James.
Wait and see.
Well, look, we gave you a long podcast last week, and it wasn't in preparation for this, but this week, nothing fucking happened.
It was pretty light.
I for real feel like the whole world took a week off getting ready for Memorial Day. So we got basketball, of course.
It's been a rough couple of weeks.
But that's all I have.
I mean, it's it's not like nothing happened. It's been like tragedy.
Tragic shit happened.
That's some shit that I don't necessarily want to pay attention to as much. So that's why, you know.
Yeah, I mean, it's whatever.
It happened. Yeah.
Because what happened last week too, right? The Buffalo joy happened.
The Buffalo joy, yeah, and then the fucking, I guess most recently,
Texas,
the school shooting or whatever.
Texas, yeah.
And then it was another one.
Right? Another one
right afterwards.
I don't know about
that. I didn't hear about any last.
Heard about
one
the first two, but
it's wild. I thought it was a third as well, but I can't recall. But yeah, I mean, it's wild out here. And then, I mean, every time this shit happens, of course, everybody. What can we do? Or calling the politicians.
Gun laws.
Stuff like that.
Going right to gun laws.
I don't know. I don't think it's an actual answer.
I don't either. That.
It's a people problem. So.
Yeah.
I mean, what's your answer? You got one?
Something could be done about the guns. The crazy shouldn't be able to get the guns. The crazy should be able to get guns.
That's fine, but they don't know if your child's not fucking crazy. Like, I can be completely sane and own a gun, but if my child is fucking insane, they don't know that, and they would still have access to a gun. And people will always have, if motherfuckers want to do evil shit, they'll find means of or ways of by doing evil shit. Like, to me, laws.
I mean, that means you gotta make it harder then.
That's
it
fine.
Shouldn't be as easy, but if it's always gonna be open.
Shit is laws for everything, and shit is readily available for most people. Like, it's laws for cocaine, but I can get the shit if I fucking want to.
That's what I was gonna say.
Type thing.
Like, isn't the idea that people that are presenting like laws need to change? Isn't the idea pretty much the same as the war on drugs? And that if we make things more difficult for these people to get a hold of drugs, maybe this will deter them. Maybe if we punish people for drugs, this will deter them.
The war on drugs is not a fair comparison to gun laws, per se. War on drugs, they was fucking locking people up in bunches. They was getting motherfuckers off the streets regardless of people.
Well, he's just saying, like, try to deter people with laws.
I don't think new gun laws is a bad idea. I don't care about this subject, to be honest with you. I think what, like Carl thinks, it's going to keep happening. It is a tragedy at the same time. It's happened so many times, like, it kind of is what it is. I don't have kids, so it's obviously less personal to me for that reason, but I just don't think anything can be done. Say they put in, like, super strict gun laws and take away a lot of gun accessibility. I mean, say that happens. I just don't think that changes anything. It's like he said, whether people get guns illegally now that want to have guns.
I mean, yeah, but it's like... Like, how can I put it? The people that are really probably most mad about, that are against that, is people that love their guns, love to get their rifles, love to get all type of shit, gun collectors. People love their fucking guns, and that's a lot of America.
I'm one.
Of course, which is a great thing. But you will also be able to get guns with these laws still. You know what I'm saying? It's like it wouldn't enable you from getting your guns if you already you do your proper shit now. You would do the same proper shit if the laws was in place. It's just a deterrent to people that can go to like a gun show and you don't have to have no checklist, no nothing, just have to have an ID and you can get a gun. That's where it becomes like fishy. Everybody shouldn't be able to access a gun just because you are of 18 years old.
No, with no restrictions, or
whatever. It's just kind of a wild thing. Like in New York, they don't play about that gun shit. You don't hear a lot of gun shit happening in New York like that. It sells a damn because the gun laws are a lot stricter. In Florida, it's different. Everybody got a strap.
They are, but it's still killings, like shootings.
Of course, it's always going to be killings.
But 56 got shot 9 times in New York.
Yeah.
It's like they had the same gun laws then. It's still one of the most violent places that you can
see. There's definite difference than being up top and seeing guns than being in the South and seeing guns. Like a definite difference. Well, you can walk around seeing mad people with guns.
I think you see less, I don't know, like crazy shit. I mean, I don't know. Overall, like, I just think overall with the laws and shit, I feel like you create a new back door when you create a new law, or maybe two or three different back doors. Like, criminals don't follow laws. I don't get why people think, oh, change it. Of course, you make it more difficult, but a criminal wasn't obeying the motherfucker anyway.
That's all you can do is make it more difficult
for them or not.
That's all you can do is make it difficult.
Yeah, I mean, right. I don't, like I said,
it's seen it happen in other countries all the time. But we're still at the top with all these shootings.
No, I don't know what you can do about it overall. It's just one of those things that people are crazy. Makes you know, like, the devil really exists, though. Sure. Right? It's got to be, because it's like, who it's the fuck situation. Wakes up with some shit like that on their mind and then actually goes and executes it? It's the difference. It's like you're a fucked up piece of shit and, like, you thinking about terrible stuff all the time. That's but to actually go and do some shit like that, it's like, nah, that's not humane.
Won't even his school. I mean,
that's the devil.
He won't even his school. The last dude, that's the shit that was wild. He was like in high school or something, and he went and shot up at elementary school. It wasn't even his school. That's he was shooting up.
I haven't heard anything about it.
It's a nut story when you look into it. Shit is wild. Like, damn, you chose to go to an elementary school and do this shit?
Yeah, no. That is super weird.
That's sick.
Not right, even, you like, generally don't see that. Only just like high school or fucking something like that. I mean, I don't know if it makes it any better either or whatever, but still it's just that
this motherfucker just ain't right.
Like I said, why?
I think you said his grandma was like working like at the school or something too.
To me, I don't get sick environments, man.
Crazy shit, bro. Yeah. Thoughts and prayers everywhere involved. Shout out to them, man.
Do you think parents should hold some responsibility for shit like that when their kids do stuff like that?
I don't understand. Like, you're talking about his parents?
Right. Do you think they should be held responsible at all?
If they got the guns from their parents. I mean, if they were their parents' guns, yeah.
Did or did not, it doesn't matter.
I mean, I think it depends on if they did something negligent. If you've got a younger kid in the house and you don't have it kept in a safe place or something, that's how they got a hold of it.
Yeah.
Then sure. If you've got a 17-year-old that like opened up the safe and stole it from you, I don't really put the blame on the parent in that situation. You know?
Right. Just demands. I mean, it's just you can tell your kid all types of shit, but at the end of the day, they make their own decisions or whatever. But I feel like in these situations, like, I don't know, I kind of have like conflicting thoughts, I guess. In these situations, I feel like these people are doing so much fucked up shit. And what they're doing is so fucked up. It's like, I feel like maybe you should have seen a sign or something like that beforehand. And it's hard for me to believe that you didn't. And maybe they did and did try to do something about it. But I feel like those questions should at least be asked first. To them, and that's not to say that's like, you know, the parents should go to jail or anything, but they should at least be asking these questions to them first to say like, hey, what were the signs prior to this?
Right. You know?
The thing that always happens, and I believe I've really not paid a lot of attention to the details from the situation this week, but I believe I saw something that was talking about like the police have been, there have been situations before this where the police had to be involved with this guy.
Or you've seen posting about it.
Seen situations like that in other ones, even if it doesn't apply here. And the tough thing, once they start talking about, oh, the police had this interaction with them, they had this, there's like signs, like you could post some crazy shit.
Mm-hmm.
But like, what do you do about that? Because for every person that has done that,
gotta be admitted or something.
Yeah, right. I mean, at that point, you just gotta, I don't know how
this person's obviously off and thinking about doing wild shit and posting about it.
You know, being
I'm not trying to disagree, but I'm saying for every situation like that, there's 300,000 people that posted threatening stuff that were like just calling out for help and nowhere near that edge where it's like, they're posting some wild shit, but this situation was never going to escalate. Yeah, it's hard. You get to point out the one after it's happened and say, well, why didn't they do anything about this?
That's true, too.
You can't really, like, arrest somebody for what you believe they may do.
Right. Because motherfuckers just post crazy shit online regardless.
Yeah.
Even if they're, you know, experiencing it or not type thing, just to get some kind of reaction or attention in general. But
this is why I don't care about the topic. I don't think there is an answer. I mean, I understand people want to talk about
it's
it. And
it's
stuff,
a circle, man. I mean, you know, it's one of the things that's just going to keep repeating itself. You're not going to be able to get rid of all of guns in the fucking world. It's never going to happen. So, I don't know. Maybe if they had like uniform gun laws across, like just a gun law for that's not different from state to state, that doesn't vary at all. maybe then you can start to have some control over things. But until we even get to that point, then
just a proper background. Not worth it's a proper background.
I mean, that seems like a reasonable, easy enough.
That's what I'm saying. You ain't got to ban. I don't think you should ban all guns.
Well, what I'm
it's
saying
a proper
is
proper background before you can just go somewhere and just walk out with a gun.
Yeah, but what I'm saying, these people are driving from different places. Like
that's where it needs to be implemented.
What is it? What the dude that shot at the people while protesting?
I got to see his crying face.
Right, right. Like, you know what I'm talking about. Is. He drove. His parents dropped him off. He didn't fucking live there. And the same guy, the other guy drove fucking 4 hours. So wherever they're coming from, I'm sure the gun laws may be different to the area they may be traveling to. So until we get like a uniform gun law, it's like, how does it change anything at all?
Exactly.
You know, if the shit's going to vary from state to state, and I can,
have different rules for out of state purchasing as well. I'm just thinking out loud.
Yeah.
I understand what you're saying, right. But like if you have to be like a resident of Illinois to be able to come in and get a gun with this kind of background check, if you're any of the bordering states,
you have harder right now,
if you was getting a driver's license. You got to go through that to get a driver's license, but you don't have to do that to get a gun. Right.
But that's how bad the gun is already.
Right.
Like you can't, I can't go to North Carolina and purchase a pistol.
Oh, really?
I have to buy it from Virginia because that's where I'm from.
I didn't know that.
But I'm pretty sure of that anyway. But what I'm saying is just what's stopping that, like, say they don't allow guns in New York, what's stopping somebody in fucking North Carolina to driving up there with theirs? Type thing. You know what I'm saying? Because there's nothing to really stop me from doing it.
I mean, there's nothing to stop you from doing it, but there's a law that you're breaking doing that, though. Like, if you get caught, there's...
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, if you get caught, that's...
But that's what anything.
It's traveling all about arms across state to state, you can't do that.
But that's what all laws are. Like, no laws in place to catch everybody.
Yeah, for sure.
If we catch you, you are
And this is why we're talking about these stories now.
Yeah.
These are the people who are not caught. This is fucking...
Yeah, well, that's another fair point. It is what it is. I hate listening to people talk about this.
Yeah.
Yeah, sad situation.
Sad thoughts and prayers to everybody involved.
Wouldn't have happened at Mr. Clark's school, I can tell you that.
Who was Mr. Clark?
Yeah, chains on the doors. Lean on me.
Oh, for sure.
You smoke crack, don't you?
Yeah. Yeah, he wasn't playing that shit. Nah. He was kicking ass himself.
Had chains on the door.
He wasn't playing that shit. He wasn't playing that shit.
What else? What else?
Y'all know what type of time we on right now, bro.
What's that? I don't know.
You know, it's just when you like going through your shit, and you got revenge on your mind at a destination that you want to get to. You got to do what you got to do to get there. You know what I'm saying?
I do know what you're saying.
So I feel like these past couple of weeks, people have been witnessing a whole revenge tour going on of a team that has been knocked out the last 3 years. By certain teams. We had to come back around in 2022 and knock all three of them out the playoffs. You know what I'm saying? That's the type of revenge I like.
It's good revenge.
Yeah.
Kevin Garnett said it best.
Sitting in the house, I'm loading up the pump. I'm loading up the Uzi. A couple of M16s.
Yeah.
A couple of 9s. I got a couple of joints with some silencers on. I'm just loading up clips.
A lot of that.
That's how we prepare for game 7. Loading up the clips with a missile launcher. Yeah. Kevin Garnett's a crazy boy.
He was popping that shit. He was talking that gun talk on there. Well, I mean, crazy. We put that right after that conversation we just had. It's crazy timing, but we know we're here now. Y'all know what I'm talking about. I'm talking about them Boston Celtics, bro. Winners of the Eastern Conference. We handled business last night.
Very good series, man. Back and forth. Eh,
kind of a good series.
I mean,
every game sucked.
In hindsight,
last 2 games was
except
good.
Except for the last 2 games. Not bad. But as far as competitive,
that last game was a blowout for 80% of the game.
I was surprised. They got
close for like 3 or 4 minutes.
I was surprised at how, like, I don't know. I think I pulled it up. It was like 39 to fucking 60 something or something. It was like they were getting their ass kicked in the second half.
Yeah.
Or no, in the second quarter. Half.
First quarter. Second quarter was shitty.
I was just surprised that the Heat were at home getting beat like that. I would have expected, at least a close game up until that point. But
I mean, that's kind of like how the last few rounds been. Like, motherfuckers been winning on the road. Yeah. We got to beat at home mad times. We beat other people in their home with mad times. But we got it done in the one that counted the most.
Yeah, ultimately, if you win a series, you're probably going to have to at least take one. You know?
Yeah.
You got to take a couple. You got to beat teams a couple times at home to win a series.
Pretty much at this point of the year.
For sure.
So what do you think? What do you think? How was the performance overall? Overall pleased? You got the dub. It's hard to not.
Got the dub. I called both series last two rounds to go to the seven games of us to get it done. And that's exactly what fucking happened. These two teams, the Bucks and the Heat, two of the better teams in the league, two of the best teams in the league, more complete teams. They have a nice bench, everything you could want for to go win a championship. But we also have that as well.
Hey, how long have the Celtics been wearing the 24 patch?
I'm guessing since he passed.
The whole team was?
Yeah. I didn't know that.
All right, so I didn't even notice the patch. I noticed the armband last night.
Yeah,
Tatum rocked the armband. Has he been wearing that?
He has, not the purple one. He's rocked a jump before. I think that was the first time he rocked the purple 24.
Yeah, he said it was game 7. It was his first time wearing it. It was like everybody know, like that when they interviewed him, everybody know what Kobe meant to me or whatever.
But yeah.
I thought it was crazy in the thinking of it, like of the old rivalry.
Yeah, right. That's what that was the first
when I was watching the game. I'm like, yo, it's wild to think like any old Celtics fan
honor a Laker
be like, this Celtic is playing in games
and rocking the purple and gold band, and that is it's kind of nuts. It's kind of nuts.
So weird, but I mean, I get it.
But the respect is so high for Kobe. They'll let that pass.
Yeah, it's Kobe. Nowadays, it doesn't matter anyway. But it was just wild watching
this. He was rocking LeBron's number on his arm. It's like, all right, what the fuck are you doing? What the fuck is you doing?
We're not doing this.
Nah. But yeah, man, I mean,
that's when I knew that the Celtics were definitely winning that game, no doubt, though. It was like, oh, they got their fucking Kobe patches on.
I'm glad you're bringing that up. Because Friday's game, which I'm glad we paused today and not on Saturday after Friday's game, which is the one we lost at home. Y'all know I post Tatum, you know, he'd be dripped out coming into the gym. I feel like every time I posted him, we won the game. Friday, he decided to come up to the joint with a fucking Coach K t-shirt on. Man. As soon as I see that t-shirt,
I knew
I wasn't posting that shit. I'm like, it's going to be a rough fucking night. I was like, this ain't the year to be posting having a Coach K shirt on. I understand you went to Duke for a year. We get it. But he's out of here. He's had a bad year.
Why are you?
His final year has been one of his worst years since it's happened to him. So I wouldn't have picked that shirt. But you know, we lost that game. I feel like it's because he rocked that shirt.
That's not the reason why.
Makes sense to me.
Just saying.
The math is there.
I feel like the drip. I'm telling you, the drip make a difference.
It's just 2 + 2 is 4, son.
The drip coming in makes a difference. When he had that shit on, you know what time it is.
Look good, feel good.
When he rocked that MJ shirt with the Kobe MJ pants, I knew what time it was that night. He got busy.
Look good, feel good.
You know what I'm saying?
Thanks a lot, Coach K.
Yeah.
Thanks for getting us to game 7.
Could have got it done in 6, but, you know, it's all good.
How nervous were you after game 6 losing at home?
After game 6, I'm like, all right. First of all, that game 6, it was a whole bunch of fuck shit going on in that final quarter.
Wait, was that the one with all the injuries?
No, that was the game before.
That game was nuts.
Everybody
was
that might have been that game. I can't fucking remember.
It all runs together. They had the one game where Jimmy left at halftime and never came back.
He was done for the game, yeah.
But so that's definitely not game 6 because Jimmy went off from game 6, right?
Yeah, he did.
Like four, that's right.
It was the game before that.
It was probably game 5 because that's what, because the Celtics lost that game. I don't know. It doesn't matter. But Jimmy got hurt, missed the whole second half. Tatum got hurt right towards the end of the game. Looked like he was like done.
Yeah.
Smart went down in the third. Rolled his ankle. Like he was done. And then he comes walking out from the back. That game was wild.
Nuts. It's fucking WrestleMania out there, Joey.
That's the NBA playoffs. It's fun to watch.
Yeah.
I mean, I hate to see guys getting hurt, but like everybody was going so hard.
Very similar teams. It's just that the Celtics are overall more talented, but like
very more
similar play styles.
That's a fact.
Type of teams or whatever, but
that's a fact.
Hey, I mean, shout out to Jimmy Butler, man. He played a pretty good series overall.
Play out his mind the last two games.
We've said this before, but I feel like I've said this before. He's got to be one of the hardest players to rank.
Yeah.
Because when he's not deciding to go crazy, He's a very good player,
he's really playoff Jimmy.
He's like he's a star. Well, yeah, and when he turns it on, like,
but I don't think he could be your best player on your team and you win a championship.
Hasn't happened. It does seem like it would be
hard to say when you've seen him get so close multiple times.
Yeah.
So you can't say there's no way when he gets there, he gets his team there.
I just don't believe so. I mean, I like Jimmy Butler overall, but I feel like you got to be like a more consistent jump shooter in order to really dominate and win a championship in today's, if you're the best player type thing. You know, he could be a number two and play the way he plays.
Are we forgetting what happened last year with Mr. Giannis?
I mean, I was going to say, that's the same. Giannis is different because Giannis is
seven feet tall. Yeah, of course. He could get into the paint anytime he wants. Jimmy Butler can do that, but before Giannis did it,
people thought it was not, you couldn't win a championship with just having a great big man and no regard. It's the same argument.
Like, you got to be built like that and being able to score 30 points every night. And again, Giannis got his game has evolved to a different level where he can give you 8 assists as well, too. Yeah. And his jump shooting vastly improved as well. So, but he did muscle his way to the basket. But again, you got to be built like this, dude, to be able to do that.
And to Jimmy be honest, I feel like Jimmy, all his whole game repertoire steps up as well. It's not just like the scoring. He's just jumping. He starts getting a little better. He's shooting threes. He doesn't shoot threes at all during the regular season. And he'll hit a couple threes in the game.
His percentage is terrible.
No, he shoots 55% from the field. That's freaking amazing.
I'm talking about from three.
No.
I mean, he shot like 20-something percent from three or something like that.
30-something.
For the whole playoffs. This series, he shot well. He didn't shoot a lot of them, but the ones he shot, he was making.
Yeah, I mean, for the playoffs and the regular season or some shit. Like, it's both pretty terrible.
I mean, yeah, regular season, he doesn't shoot threes at all, really. It's not even his game.
Except for last night.
That's a regular season.
Well, I was just saying, except for last night, he shot a three.
That's just the playoffs. Okay. I said the regular season, he doesn't do it. The playoffs, he does.
Well, if he does it, you'll think his percentage would be better.
He low-key has a DeRozan-type game.
Right, exactly.
Where that's the part that's hard to see carrying a team with that.
So I think DeRozan is a better mid-range shooter overall, but
yeah, he is
very, very.
But similar. I think Jimmy's a better player.
I wouldn't disagree.
Jimmy's a better player.
But it's hard to see those mid-range guys being like take over. He did. He had the 47 point game. He took over that game, but that's hard to.
He did hit three threes in that game.
A sustainable 40 point guy throughout the series when those are the types of shots that you specialize.
It's tough to put up those numbers with just twos.
Yeah.
You got to have some threes in there.
I don't think of him as like that scary of an offensive player. He's a good player
all the way around.
Yes.
I feel like you got to have an actual number one on your team to take to a championship. And I don't think Tyler Hero could be that guy. You know, maybe, but
he was banged up.
Yeah. I mean, that hurt him a lot too.
But the other thing, when you get to this level of the playoffs, like it's all the support guys that make the difference.
Exactly.
And their support guys sucked.
I've been saying this. Max Strus
was terrible this series.
Yeah.
Lowry wasn't very good. Hero was hurt, but he didn't impact the series at all. Duncan Robinson, they had starting almost all year.
They took him all out the lineup altogether.
What happened?
He got taken out in the first series, I think, and he just turned into like Steven Adams. They did the same thing with him in Memphis, where they played better without him, and he just dropped out of the rotation.
Don't you think it would have been worth to even try it? Like, I mean, I guess if
they did. You got to implement that Duncan and Harrell are defensive liabilities.
For sure.
Like, they can't guard nobody on our starting five. When it comes down to it. Yeah. So, you know, you're losing on that side of the floor for them to potentially hit some threes for you.
Yeah.
And that's what you don't want to have to deal with.
Yeah, I can't argue with that, but what they had didn't work. I don't think Jimmy had enough help.
I thought last night they stopped playing PJ Tucker.
That is weird.
And PJ Tucker has been a menace for us the whole series. He's always a menace. Hurt? I don't know if he was hurt or not.
He had to have been because he's like, they count on him.
Yeah, it was like he didn't play the whole second half. They didn't stop playing him.
That is weird.
Has Oladipo been? Has he had a good?
They played Oladipo for like 30 plus minutes instead of PJ Tucker.
He's played solid.
I thought he was terrible last night.
I don't notice him on the court that much.
He had a couple games where he was hitting. He had a couple games where he was just off like a bitch.
Yeah.
But he's great defensively, though. So you want a guy like that to stay on the floor. He was playing great defense.
But on the opposite end, all those guys that they had struggle. And y'all have random games where Horford goes off.
Robert Williams.
Or even just produces above what he's supposed to.
Right.
Yeah. Robert Williams. Grant Williams is the same thing.
Yeah.
Marcus Smart is not a superstar, but he had random games where he was like the guy.
The guy.
And you know you've already got the other two that one of them is going to be on.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I don't know. That was a weird series. I don't know what to expect the next one.
Shout out to Al, though, man. Give it up to Al, man. First time making the finals, 140-some playoff games in his career. This is his first time making it to the NBA Finals.
Before we skip on to the finals, do y'all think the Jimmy Butler shot was a bad shot that he took at the end?
I say no. I'm glad he took it. Instead of taking it to the cup, I'm glad he took that three because that's not his strong point. But it was a wide open three for the lead of the game. He was tired as shit, obviously. He played the whole game.
They were down by two at the time.
Yeah, it was down by two. It was to take the lead.
Down the court, got Horford on him.
Yeah.
Is Horford with a little shake or something?
Horford was playing off of him. He played to the paint because he thought Jimmy's going to drive it.
Jimmy, he had a wide open three.
Wide open three.
It was a stop and pop.
Big time shot.
13 seconds left. And it just
you got to live and die with the big time shots. He's a star player. If he hits it, he's the greatest shot of the year.
Right. I'm not mad for a shot. When I saw it, I said, but that's a good shot, though. Even if he's not a great three-point shooter. I think they said, like,
he's clutch.
In those situations, like, stop and pop, he does shoot like 47% from three.
Yeah, he's clutch.
But, and he had made a similar shot to that earlier in the game as well.
I think he took that shot because he was fucking winded. He didn't take no bench. He didn't hit the bench at all the game. He
survived in overtime.
That's what I'm saying. He didn't want that shit to go to overtime.
They would have got blown out by 20 points. They would have had to end it right then and there.
That's why I think he shot that three.
I don't think anybody could say, you're supposed to take it to the cup and do what after?
Well, that's what I would say.
Jimmy was gassed, bro.
Now, I'm not saying it was a bad shot. Well, you got your best player taking an open three.
Yeah.
It is what it is.
That's what you want.
I wouldn't want him to take that shot because that's not his game.
True.
But I think if Jimmy gets the rebound and we pause the game when he's crossing half court,
mm-hmm.
if you're a Celtics fan, you hope he takes a three.
Yeah, of course.
But it's still
the same time.
That's how I would look.
I was holding my breath when that shit went up.
Of course.
You know what I'm saying? There's a great chance that shit could have failed. So
I don't think it was a bad look. But I would have preferred he just got the bucket.
Yeah, but
and the possible and one.
That boy Jimmy was just gassed, man. He played the whole game. No rest except for a halftime between quarters.
Yeah, that is, you don't see that happen a lot anymore.
There's certain players that's built like that. In a game seven situation, they'll go the whole game. We've seen LeBron do it. We've seen certain players. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, just not often.
Yeah, got to have your guys out there. But, you know, got it done, man. We in that thing.
Are you okay?
We can get on to the real shit, man.
Are you okay with Luka now since he didn't get swept?
Say, am I okay with him?
Yeah.
I'm being okay with Luke.
All right.
I just like to bring up questions, you know, spark thought a little bit.
You won't be keeping the same energy, bro.
What you mean? I've always said he's a top 10 player. What do you mean?
And others. You don't keep the same energy.
How? Explain.
I'm just saying. I don't have a good example off top right now, but. You really don't like Luka.
Yeah, it's just one of those times.
I wish
you would jump on and just admit that you're a hater.
But I never say I don't like Luka though. I just don't like people giving over the top praise for people that haven't done much yet.
Understood.
That's all I'm saying. That's all we try to keep it at. Just keep that same energy. Though we give them making somebody top five in the league because they finally had a great playoffs. You know what I'm saying? Like, come on.
Since we've got nothing but time and we did have this conversation in the chat.
Yeah.
You said if you get swept, you can't be top five. That's what you said, right?
For the year. Just off the season specifically.
So I know we had this talk after the first round sweep, but KD is not top five this year.
Not this season. And that's, not this playoffs.
That's
crazy. He was not top five. I mean, what would you want me to say?
For the season.
He had terrible games. He got swept.
We talked about him.
Like, what are we talking about? What I would say is if KD is at least supposed to get you one game.
Yeah.
That's for sure. Like,
you hear the same thing with Luka. He's gonna at least get the Warriors for one.
That's so stupid. If them winning one meaningless game changes what you think of them as a
it doesn't
player,
change it, but it's way better than getting swept.
Duh.
It's way better than getting swept.
Way better if they won two games.
I think overall, the next I don't know how many more years KD is gonna play, but it's going to dictate a lot about what we think about KD going forward, especially if Golden State continues to compete for championships.
Like making that comparison, though.
It's fair.
He ain't got nothing to do with that. They won before him. They're going to win. They can win after him. It's like, what are we talking about?
I mean, no doubt, but it just it shows that he needed them for sure. And I'm not saying like the partnership wasn't mutual. Like, they, of course, needed KD to kind of get over that LeBron hump.
Exactly.
At the time, but
it was a mutual benefit.
It almost sit here to say, like, oh, they would have done it eventually without him.
I mean, at this point, because who's not in the playoffs? LeBron. That's what they needed KD for, because LeBron was such a fucking force. I mean, there's no other player that's playing right now that brings that much level of, that LeBron or KD does, so to speak.
I mean, it's just a fair conversation to have for KD.
I don't know if it's fair. He's moved on, man. Let him move on.
And got swept. That's what. And then at that point, like, if say he doesn't make the playoffs next year, or say he gets swept again next year, like, come on, dog. It's really gonna take a hit to your legs.
It's a false comparison. We're talking about a Warriors team that's been together for almost a decade, and a team that's been together maybe a year total. 2 years, like, this is a new first team.
I did want to bring this up too, and that's the reason why I have so much respect for the Celtics. It's because it's the same as organically grown,
homegrown,
built from. I mean, you have some free agent,
but that shit takes time though,
here and there, right? But nobody wants to really put that in.
Because the other thing that
is a lot like Golden State type
getting glossed over a little bit is that Boston has been made fun of for like 4 years.
What you mean by that?
I mean, like, y'all have been
falling short.
Yeah, you've been a team that people have been like, oh, I don't know, this team might be able to make a run. And then when it's fallen short, it's been like, I don't know, they don't have it. They didn't build what they're supposed to build.
They've been trying to break us up for the last 3 years.
This player, maybe this player should be traded. So, like, that's the type of shit. That's what I think. That's what Carl's getting at too.
But Golden State went through the same thing.
That's why y'all deserve praise right now.
Yeah.
Because nobody listened to that.
Exactly.
Nobody listened and made the stupid
people that have those jump to conclusion, oh, you got to trade, you got to break them up every time you lose. You're not looking to build on your team by doing it that way, trying to break it up every time y'all fail in the playoffs. These are young guys.
Bro,
we have a very, very young squad. Our oldest player is Al Horford, 35, and everybody else is around in their mid-20s or younger on the team. That's what you want to build up and keep building on every single year
until
you get to this point.
What the Lakers could have been right now. Like, with all of the young talent they had, Brandon Ingram, fucking Jordan Clarkson, Lonzo Ball, D'Angelo Russell. All of them left and became better players.
At the same time, the Lake Show does their fucking shit different. They're the Lake Show. They have to have showtime on the field. I mean, on the field, on the court, every year. Boston doesn't buy into it. We have to put on the show and have thrill every season. No, we're trying to build for championships. It's just different perspective.
The Lakers want to win championships too.
Of course they do. I mean, but they also wanted to have stars on their court too. Yeah. They have to have stars.
Ultimately what I'm saying is the Celtics did it the right way. I believe in that philosophy. I think the Buccaneers did it the right way. I believe in those philosophies of building
the foundation.
And I just feel like you have a more sustained success. I mean, the Bucks. I mean, I didn't know if it's with
the Milwaukee Bucks.
Yeah.
Okay. No, you said the Buccaneers, and I was like,
"Oh, I didn't mean to say that."
They did not build internally.
No.
Sign everybody.
I'm with you. But I feel like, all right, yeah, you can definitely pop and get a championship out of it, maybe, or get close to it. But at the same time, it's like sustained success. Are you gonna be back here next year competing again?
All the good teams are like that.
Right. It's the
same. Miami is the same thing.
Retain them. Yeah, right.
Mm-hmm. Even Philly has built internally. It took them forever.
Trust the process. They had a whole theme with their.
And that's not to say you can't get any free agents, because all these teams have agents and trade acquisitions and stuff like that. But it's just ultimately my core base of guys we drafted and developed or brought in and developed at a very early age. Like, they set the culture. Shit that matters.
That used to be how free agency was like thought of, I think.
It's a supplement.
Yeah, it's like an add-in piece. We can get the one or two pieces that we're missing, not like whole teams free agents, so let's get a new team.
That became
more of the model.
Yeah, and I don't fill in spots, which I think was our issue in the last few seasons. We didn't have a big man presence.
Yeah.
Our big man presence was obsolete, and I said, as soon as we get a decent center, which we was building up Robert Williams. We had drafted him, but he wasn't ready yet. He was young. He didn't have.
How many years has he been in the league?
I think this is his third year.
That's what I was thinking, too.
I think this is his third year. He actually came into his own this year. He led the league in blocks, second team all defense. He stepped his shit up, so he was worthy. And we picked up Al, which I'm so glad we picked Al back up. When he left us, he was trying to get a max out of us, and we didn't want to pay that max because I don't know if he was worth that max.
He wasn't.
But, you know, because he went to Philly, he got that max, and he didn't do so great. But
he's a good player, though.
He's a guy that just you want to go win a championship with. That'll help you win a championship. He's that veteran that's going to do what he has to do every game and make plays, step up when he has to, and be a fucking terror on defense. I love it. That's really the most important thing. I love it.
Right. It's, yeah. And that's what Celtics, I mean, that's why it's so scary looking at the Golden State matchup. It's just because they can defend at every position. And I'm not saying that Golden State can't. They have a pretty good defense as well, too, I think, or at least coach well defensively. So it's going to be an interesting series, but
I've been seeing a lot of disrespect, man.
The Celtics.
Warriors in five. Warriors in six, maybe at the most.
I think it's a possibility.
Whew.
But I think that's a possibility for sure. But I could also see the Celtics winning in seven pretty easily as well, too. It's just all depends on how it shapes out.
At best, I think we can get them in six. But I'm going to lean towards seven as well.
I look at it this way. If it took seven games for the Celtics to deal with the Heat, it's at least going to take seven games for you to deal with the Warriors.
I think the Heat are a better team than the Warriors.
You are smoking, really? Dog.
I think the Heat were a better team.
Over the course
of the year, the Heat were the better team.
How so? In what area?
East, bro. I mean,
the East had the better teams than the West.
The West, I feel like, has like the better players and stuff like that overall.
Nah. What? The East is better than the West this year. Facts.
You suck on Jaws' meat. Fucking
facts. That's Jaws. Don't do that. I never did that. Don't do that, bro.
But I'm just saying, bro. I think if you haven't watched
till like last week, I watched the whole season. The Heat was one of the best teams in the league. They were the number one seed for a reason.
What areas do you think they excel at more?
I think they had a deeper team.
Okay.
They had a deeper team. They had the big man presence. They got inside game. They played great top tier defense. They got shooters all over the place, which they had played well, but a lot of shooters was hurting the playoffs or whatever. And they got Jimmy Butler. Like, I just feel like they were one of the better teams. I feel like they were a better team than the Warriors. Of course, Steph is probably the best player out of the two teams, of course. But as a team, as a whole, bench included, what did you bring it in? The Heat was a better built team.
Oh, I don't buy that at all. I feel like top to bottom, the Warriors, probably the best team in the NBA.
So Looney is better than Bam?
I'm not saying that, but we're talking about.
Nah, but if you put team up
but if we're talking about player for player, you go take three Warrior players before you take a Heat player.
I think it would be 2-1.
Three of the top four
would go to Golden State.
Right. They got better players, and they're like, they play together for years. It's cohesive. I think it's not even close.
I just think the Heat were better.
The Warriors would have beat the Heat in five games.
Okay.
No doubt about it.
They're not there, I'm not going to refer to what they did.
Jimmy Butler would have been Luka Doncic. You know what I'm saying? It's the same guy. Jimmy Butler would have went off.
Do you think the Heat is better than the Mavs?
Yeah, I do.
Okay.
Like handed.
Yeah.
Like, for, without a doubt.
I'm just saying, that's what would happen, though.
The, so I wouldn't make that comparison with the Luka team. The Luka team is trash compared to the Heat team. Facts. Facts. Luka is the main and sole reason why they got where they got to.
Yeah, I mean, you could say that, but still, I feel like the Warriors would have dusted their ass. And, I mean, Celtics could make this a great fucking series, no doubt. But to me, this is the Warriors' title to take.
Who's the home team?
Warriors.
Warriors, they had the better.
Yeah, they got the first two at home.
I'm taking Golden State in seven, if I gotta guess. I don't care who wins, though.
Understood.
If Celtics win, I got no problems with that. You got them in seven.
Yeah.
I'm going to take the Warriors in six on that six. One. But, wait, like, again, like or, it. You know, like again, I think the I'm not, this is not a cop-out, but the Celtics can make this a series in seven. Very possible. And I do feel like the Kobe touch is in effect to a certain degree. I feel like, you know, a lot of these players he's put his thumbprint on have won titles, you know, in recent years. Kawhi, Giannis, and now Jason Tatum has his opportunity. But I really do feel like that's a thing as well.
That would be wild if it's just every year.
I feel like it's
Kobe
it's,
disciple.
Yeah, right.
Watch
right,
out
right,
for
right.
the Nets next year.
I roll with it.
I mean, and I mean, they're definitely running out at this point because it's not like you can train anybody else. But
really,
the list is short.
Yeah, it is. But, hey, I think it's a real possibility.
I'm glad y'all keeping the same energy. Y'all have kept all series. Y'all have doubted us every round. So,
I think I have.
I'm glad y'all keeping this so we can keep what we've been doing on the response to that.
This round.
Did you?
Yeah, I took the Celtics. Bro.
Did you?
Definitely had the Nets.
Oh, okay.
Who was the second round?
Bucks.
Definitely
had the Bucks. Mm-hmm. And still think if Middleton's there, it happens. But
hey, I had y'all everybody got injuries.
This is true. This is true.
And I'm a fan of Jason Tatum, man. That boy's nice.
I'm a bigger fan of Smart. That's my guy.
On one issue
There's
with
been
us.
Moments where I hated that dude.
I love Marcus Smart.
He's become one of my favorite
That's
players.
Been my guy.
I mean, they can really give Golden State some fits.
It's my guy for life.
There's going to be a game. That Boston wins by 20.
Yeah, I'm sure of it.
And they have like
Golden
terrible
State shooting gets
percentages.
Dumb sloppy. And if they start getting
they lead the league in turnovers.
Yeah.
That's a real stat.
There's going to be a lot of turnovers.
We're going to have one of them games where we're going to dog them on defense.
Y'all just take the ball away from people sometimes. It's like fucked up. It's kind of rude.
Yeah.
Should be fun.
Well, then we got to fix though. It's what was pissing me off the last two games. I got to get this out. When we get in the lead or an advantage situation, we start jacking threes instead of going to the cup. And it really pisses me off. It's like, yo, we up. We don't have to keep jacking threes. Go to the hole. Drive to the basket. Make them foul you. Drive to the basket. Make them foul you. Do something. Put some pressure on them while you got the lead instead of jacking threes and letting them come back and get easy layups.
That's
to get back
a wild
in the game.
Idea.
That shit was pissing me off. Why I'm like, yo, y'all that? Jacking threes, they're going right down to the back bucket, going right to the lane, getting the easy layups. Bam. Jimmy. It's like, yo, they're not even shooting threes. Like, they weren't even shooting threes. They was going straight to the bucket, and we jacking threes while we up 15. I'm like, yo, y'all is wilding. Y'all trying to blow this shit. Just jacking all these fucking threes. Get to the basket. None of them can guard you going to the basket. Do it.
Yeah. That is a wild idea to just start jacking threes at that moment.
Shit is killing me.
Who does Draymond guard?
Oh yeah, I guess probably put him on Smart or fucking
Al Horford.
Horford. He can guard one of them.
He probably get Looney. I don't know. If we start Horford and Robert Williams, he gotta play one of them.
I wonder who guards Tatum. That's my
Williams.
Question. I guess you'll put Wiggins on him, or
Wiggins will play, and Clay will probably get some turns.
Is Clay the same defender? You know, he's a good defender.
Who's better? I doubt he's still the same defender, but who else would be better?
I mean, you got to use him.
Yeah,
he's a star.
So I don't know. I mean, I'm scared for the Warriors ultimately, but
don't be scared for them. Man. They're Warriors.
Well, I mean, I just think that this is definitely going to be a tougher matchup than, I don't know, some people think it's going to be.
This will be the toughest matchup they've had all playoffs. Facts.
For sure.
Easily.
Facts.
For Easily. Sure.
Well, what else?
You know.
Was there anything good come out of that Kyrie interview? This was a couple weeks ago now. I am athlete, whatever one it was.
Yes, I'm athlete. This is a decent interview. It was cool. It was like he was answering most of the questions that people asked. I didn't like how they didn't really touch on his time in Boston like that. They was mostly talking about him with the Cavs and why he left LeBron and all this shit like that. But he was just, you know, basically shooting down all the, you know, that him and LeBron was beefing. That's why they broke up and all this shit. Or he left. Mm-hmm. It was just, they just wanted to go on their own path. He's like, it was mainly, he talked about the Cavs. The Cavs had a different look at the future than what both of them could agree with. What Kyrie could agree with.
Gotcha.
So that was more of the issue with him. He felt like it was better for him to just go on ahead and leave, which is understandable.
Yeah.
Like, people hated him. Like, you left LeBron and now you're going to lose forever. It's like, all right, bro, like, do you want him to tag along with LeBron everywhere he went? Like, I don't understand.
Yeah. Yeah. I saw some of that. I don't. Never had that strong enough of an opinion on that. Did you?
He got like the KD effect when KD left. That same type of shit. Like, why would you leave LeBron? You won a championship with him. To go play on your own team, be your own guy.
One of the things, he wanted to be his own man, but I always saw it as, okay, he'll never win another ring. That's what I thought when he did that. I don't see Kyrie as a guy that he got to be your number two. I don't think he could be your best player to win a championship. So that was my initial thought. I didn't really think about it much after that again.
I think I was excited when it happened because I was wanting the Cavs to break up. But
oh yeah,
could be wrong. I'm sure that was my take though.
How did Kevin Love get left as a fucking?
Nobody cares about Kevin Love.
I'm still stuck there.
He's fucked up.
He had a nice contract.
He did.
He was getting paid,
and now he's on the new Cavs come up.
Yeah,
part of the
like the OG, the
new
bet.
Generation.
Yeah, nothing wrong with that.
No.
What else? What else happened?
What else did happen?
We got anything music related?
You mentioned that interview.
What interview?
With Button.
Oh, Isaiah Rashad?
Yeah, you have to tell us what happened.
I didn't see
it.
Isaiah Rashad interview.
I always saw that clip that you said.
That was a pretty interesting interview. I mean, it was pretty decent. They talked about, of course, his shit, his video and tape and all that shit. I mean, he basically just addressed it like, yeah, I mean, I didn't feel I needed to let everybody know what I was doing in my personal life.
What
it was also shit like that. That shit came out, so I had to, you know, feel like I had to address it then.
What did this tape that everybody's talking about come out? What is that?
Oh, he had a sex tape of him topping some guy off.
What?
Get leaked. You didn't know about that?
Hell no, I didn't
know about
that
on here.
Yeah, I thought I brought that
up.
We didn't talk about it on the pod because it wasn't really nothing to talk about. It was just a video. But it was like, it was a pretty big deal.
Yes, a couple of months ago at this point.
Yeah.
But nothing had been addressed, so he never said anything about it. Nobody ever, like.
I honestly don't know who, like, I know who he is, but I'm not.
He probably wouldn't know about his music. He's signed TDE.
I haven't heard.
He's got pretty good music.
He's pretty fire.
You would like it, but I mean, like, it's more, I think it's good. He can rap.
You wouldn't like it because you don't like any TDE. You don't like any TDE artists, so I wouldn't suggest that you would like his music at all.
Probably not.
I was going to joke that, I've never listened to this guy's music.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Understood.
Influenced me.
But he can rap. He can spit.
In any kind of way.
Top
hey,
dog.
Yo, I feel like, whatever.
Apparently.
Yeah.
TDE.
Top dog entertainment.
It's nuts. But it was a good interview. It wasn't nothing like crazy that was said. They was having conversations about his childhood, you know, how he's brought up, his place in this game type of shit. He was just, you know, he just think he's regular, bro. Never felt like, he basically explained it like, I didn't think people cared about what my personal life that much for me to have to express that to people. That, you know what I'm saying? So I don't know.
I don't care however he wants to do it.
Yeah.
However he wants to do it. But if a few of the clips that I've seen made it seem like he was like surprised it was even a thing.
Yeah, yeah. That's how he responded to it.
Me.
But then he said he went to like an immediate.
This was, of course, going to be a huge news thing. If you've never indicated or hinted at the fact that you're gay or bi, whatever you claim to be, and then this comes out, I mean, he's never carried it. I don't know. That's weird. That's weird to me.
I can see it, though, because, like, before that happened, whoever talks about Isaiah Rashad, like, he's never brought up for anything. So it's like, for that to happen, he probably thought, like, all right, like, damn, like, why y'all caring about this? Of course, if I think in hindsight, he thinks, like, I understand why people reacted to it the way that they did, but I just didn't. Before that, I feel like nobody really cared that much about what I was doing personally. I gotcha. Which I agree with. People barely even, I don't think that many people even listen to his music like that. So it's like.
Nah, he's definitely a smaller artist, but.
Yeah.
Interesting.
So, you talk about, but he said he went to a little depression. He said it was wild what he said happened afterwards, though. He's like, 2 days later, his granddad died, and he got in, like, 2 car wrecks. One, he, like, intentionally was, like, trying to commit suicide type shit. So he's like, the after effects of it, he really kind of went through it because he felt like it was affecting his family a lot because they weren't prepared for that type of, you know what I'm saying, shit to come out. He said a few of his family members knew about sexuality and shit. He said, but not his whole family.
You should have told him to put the camera down. Yeah. I mean, you gotta stop these problems before they happen.
Yeah.
He
said that too. He's like, yeah, of course, in hindsight, I'm thinking, like, yeah, why the fuck did I do that? Or some shit. Like, he's like, but again, he said he didn't expect it to ever come out either. So,
whatever. That's
what I think that's most people when it comes to this.
True, true, true. It's always the case.
Yeah, I mean, hey.
What was they saying, though? Too crazy.
I'll probably check out the interview. I forgot about
it. That. And y'all got to check out that XXXTentacion documentary on Hulu. Shit is crazy.
He just dropped a song with Kanye.
Kanye, yeah.
What Kanye got?
That was new?
Yeah.
I didn't know.
Yeah, it was new record.
I mean, I didn't know people were still streaming X's music like crazy like that, but he's still like.
He has the most streamed album on Spotify. I'm sure, like, at 31 billion.
Yeah.
Some shit like that.
He got. He inspired a lot. Again, I would always say it wouldn't be a Juice WRLD without X first. Like, he pretty
did
much
he come
was
first?
That. Yeah.
Hey, you. But I didn't know he came out first.
Yeah.
But, yeah, his story is just wild, though. Like, from, like, 16 to when he died at 20, I think it was. Those 4 years of his life is wild.
Yeah.
Just how he blew up and all this shit, his domestic violence shit. Like, he was just a wild boy. A
lot of up and down circumstances and shit.
Like, but, like, the worst shit that happened to him was why he blew up. From beating up his girlfriend.
Yeah.
Like, that mugshot with his dreads, that became a viral mm-hmm. mugshot for him. And I think he made his album cover, too, or some shit like that.
It was definitely on some merch. That's for sure.
Yeah. It was just wild to see that. That was why he blew up. So they was just going into how he, like, bought into being like the villain guy or whatever, and that's what made him blow up. But then after he got his success, he started understanding that this villain shit ain't really what it's cracked up to be. So he started, like, change his life and be more positive and do shit like that. And then, of course, he ended up
the dude getting killed. A really, really special artist, though, man. If you listen to his music, it's unlike
his music is
most people.
He can do it all.
He was not a rapper at all. I mean, you could really. This shit was really like that soft rock type shit for the most part.
He made rock. He had R&B joints. He was singing.
He's really,
rapping.
Really talented. Like, that's the. I really, like, when he passed away, that was the first time I listened to his music. And I was like, damn, why did I?
He was hella talented. Hella talented.
I listened to this dude's shit before. Like, I really enjoyed the stuff that I heard from him. I haven't listened to him in a long time, but like I said, just an extremely talented.
Yeah, that 17 album was crazy. It's a crazy album.
Yeah.
I've only heard random songs, but I do know what you're talking about, where you'll hear none of the songs sounded the same, like, not even remotely close. They sound like totally different.
The song that blew him up, the Look At Me shit, is not at all like his actual style that he normally, like, it was like I said, generally on some soft rock type
stuff. Which is another, like, kind of wild, well, not even wild, but he blew up because of those hype crowd rocking songs, like Travis Scott level type songs. And when he got on his next album, he did a whole pivot from that and didn't have no songs like that. It was all like soft,
real mellow
type music, which is like, a lot of people was like, I don't know if you should do this. People want to hear that shit from you. And he was like, nah, I want to do this now. It's like, you don't see artists do that a lot when they're like on their come up, on their rise, bubbling to just switch their whole music up that people loved them for. And he was successful with it. That hits. That sad record is crazy.
That's one of the ones I know the most. Yeah. Interesting. I'll have to check it out. That just came out this past week.
Yeah, I think so.
I didn't even know about it.
Pretty good.
I forgot all about it. I seen like a trailer or two for it, but I didn't know it dropped on real. So
yeah.
I'm definitely going to check that out, though.
Hard.
Shout out to that boy.
It's crazy.
Florida boy.
Was there any new music at all that you guys listened to? I don't know if I even added like random singles.
But yet I did listen to that exit Kanye shit.
Lobby Boys. Y'all gotta check out that Lobby Boys.
What's
that? Fuck is Mano and Jim Jones. But wait.
Where did I see them on interview?
$1 million worth of game.
That's what it was.
I'm not listening to no man.
I know you're probably not gonna listen to them. The shit is fucking hard though. Flames, bunch of flips, hard records.
Mano rap though.
What'd you say
there? Yeah, Mano can rap.
What'd you say they're called?
Lobby Boys with a Z at the end.
I don't know if I ever heard a good Mano song, but maybe I just don't know what I'm talking about.
Mano can rap. Probably. Mano can rap.
You think Mano can rap?
I don't know. Just you probably don't know what you're talking about.
Mano can't rap, bro.
You can't say you can't rap and you don't never listen to his music.
Yeah,
I've heard some songs. I've heard some songs of Mano. And
you heard High Hater?
I've come away with this. Yeah, this guy is not a good rapper.
All the above with T-Pain.
That was the one that
you heard those. But he makes a lot of some decent
that
projects.
That song is fire.
I mean, but if you can't rap all those type of stuff, then what makes me think that you can rap all?
I mean, those records weren't meant for him to be getting in his bag rapping. They was like singles.
He struggles to rhyme.
It's not true. Well, check out the Lobby Boys album. The shit is hard. If you say that shit ain't hard, then
he's not going to listen to that
album. He's probably not, but
I might check it out. I like Jim Jones.
But it's hard, though. I fuck with it.
That's random, though. I didn't even know that came out. I did see them on that interview, but.
Yeah, they haven't put out little snippets here and there. You know, I follow them or whatever. I definitely follow Jim Jones. I fuck with Jim Jones. Put out little snippets that sound hard. Flip some like the early 2000s hip hop records. There's some hard records on there.
I saw you had Fabio on there.
Yeah.
That one was a flip.
Yes. 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 Slide. It's a hard record.
Well, I thought.
Did y'all ever listen to NBA Youngboy and Quavo song?
NBA Youngboy and Quavo.
It was Don't Rape Me.
I did, actually.
I thought it was pretty good.
This is from like 2 weeks ago, right? Yeah. I listened to it at the airport. I don't remember it, to be honest with you.
It's the best rapping I've heard from NBA Youngboy.
Really?
It's like him actually switching up flows, mid, verse and shit. I thought it was pretty good. Other than that, man, I think it's been kind of dry.
Oh, he this Chance record. He put out another record.
I was going to say he had another one. I didn't listen to that one.
A bar about a bar? Oh, is he getting to it again?
You said you listened to that Lupe Autobado?
Yeah.
I thought it was pretty good.
Yeah. Yeah, I told you. I was surprised at how good it sounded.
Yeah, it sounded like old Lupe. It sounded like, not like Food Liquor Lupe, but whatever the
Superstar
was on. No.
was cool.
The cool.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah, look at you checking that out, huh?
Yeah. at you.
I mean, I like Lupe, bro.
It was a John Legend featuring J.I.D.
I did listen to that one. That was a pretty good record.
Yeah, that was cool. Anything he's on is weird. It's a good way.
It's a kind of odd feature for him to have on a John Legend record.
Yeah.
I wouldn't have expected that. But
he had another one, too, that is on the radio right now. Super weird feature. He's a weird dude. It kind of makes sense.
Yeah, you got to do something to get your name out there like that, you know?
True.
Fucking rap.
I didn't listen to anything this week at all. Not anything new.
Yeah, it wasn't too much to drop. There's a couple R&B joints.
Didn't you say you listened to that Brandy freestyle?
Oh, yeah. There's no way gave that boy Jack Harlow some bars.
Brandy
on the first class beat.
Mine right now. I do not.
Yo, that shit was hilarious, yo. But when she got into her jack bars, when she was, I'm a jack of all trades. You can't jack. I'm a jack your beat. She was doing a bunch of jack flips. I was like, yo, wrote this for you. Who wrote that? Made her say this shit.
I'm not going to lie. I thought it was awful.
I thought it was not that good.
It's the last thing. How old is Brandy?
She's probably in her 40s.
Brandy in her 50s, probably.
She's not that old. I don't think she's in her 50s.
Carl had 10 years on anybody.
I got to see it now. I hope y'all
is probably in her 50s. You should be doing
41.
I give her mid-40s at best. 40s.
No, no, bro. Roisha was a long time ago.
It was.
43.
So she in her 50s. So, no, I thought it was awful. Like, why is Brandy doing this? What point is she trying to prove?
I don't think she mean no ill intent. I think she was just having fun doing some shit like that because they try to make a big deal about him not knowing that Brandy and Ray J were siblings. So I was like, all right. It was some fun she was trying to have with it.
That's what I took it as.
Y'all think Jack responds, though?
No.
Yeah, definitely.
No chance.
Jack don't give a fuck about that.
He should put it on a remix and have her sing the hook.
I'm sure he will.
That would be fire.
I'm sure he's going to do something like that.
That might be fire.
Mr. Pay Homage.
Stop that. Stop that shit immediately.
That was nuts. Jack of all trades. I'm jacking your beat. Like, what? I was like, whoa. Calm down, Miss Norwood.
Why is she rapping?
What else we got, though, man?
I got nothing.
Yeah, I got something that can spoil y'all's childhood. My mom talked about the MTV Cribs was fake. Yeah. The And One was fake, too.
Nah.
Shit was fucking fake, bro.
And One?
And One was Street Ball Harlem Globetrotters.
This guy's a monster.
Shit is nasty.
I didn't know that. How you know it was fake?
Because it was.
Nah, how do you know that?
I did a little, seen people talking about it. The moves they was doing was real moves. They had talent. They had that skill. But who they was playing,
Find out a CGI this whole time.
Not like the shit they was doing. But it was like, it wasn't real basketball. Spider-Man. I think we all know that it wasn't real basketball. It wasn't no rules. You could double dribble. Right, it was a bunch of shit, but who they was playing was just like kind of a couple of the same guys. They would pick some people from whatever city they was to be on the team, but they was playing kind of like the same people on the tour they was on.
Nah, I don't believe that.
It's sick, though.
All right, but
I'm not buying it.
So you said the outcome of the games was rigged?
More so like who they would, like how the Globetrotters do. Not that they travel with a full team that they're playing, but they have guys that they put on the other team that they're playing. Every state and city they're going to. You know what I'm saying?
I can see that. Yeah, because you want to make it like it's entertainment. You don't want to fucking, these guys can't.
Exactly. You don't want to run into a team to actually bust y'all's ass while y'all in y'all's still. You know what I'm saying? So it's that sort of thing where they was making sure they was catering to winning. They weren't playing that great of defense type shit.
Right, because that's not what the, I mean, I can see that because it's not what the like audience is or what the game is catered to. Like, it's not about actually playing basketball.
But it's just kind of disheartening.
I don't believe that.
Thinking back like, oh, they was just going around the country dogging motherfuckers. It was just
they were legit like that. None of what he's saying is true.
I'm not saying they won't skill basketball wise.
Professor
they
on
was.
IG still.
But you can't, House Sauce, you can't put the ball on your shirt and push it around. That's not a carry. Like, you can't do that.
Definitely not a carry.
But who created some of these moves?
Yeah.
That move was so sick.
Also, every game he's going to bounce the ball off his head and the dude don't see that coming.
Yeah, everybody did that move. I mean, that bounce ball off the head, that's effective though. That shit actually works. Some people would not see it coming.
Where are you researching how to ruin everything that you enjoyed as a kid?
It's not even me researching. I feel like these new age people are researching this stuff and trying to just tear down our childhood.
Quit watching it. Quit listening.
It's the internet, bro. I be seeing Twitter. Man. They be going crazy.
Just got to scroll past anything that says N1 is fake. That's not real.
It's nuts, man. Nuts. I got another one too, but I'll save it for next week.
Hey, we got nothing but time, my friend.
I mean, all right, we can get into it. Pimp Your Ride, fake as fuck.
Oh, yeah, that's what I was going to say.
Fake as shit.
We knew that.
I always thought, like, why the fuck does this guy need a hot tub in this shit? Like,
put a whole aquarium in the trunk. What are we doing?
Is this legal?
No chance.
And that's what they say, like, some of the shit they actually have to take out of people's cars after.
So they could leave.
Of course.
Right, just so they can leave. With the shit, and then like
it was all for the show.
They don't do any engine work to half the cars or most of them.
They brought up this one episode where Tiffany Haddish was one of the people on the show.
I
was like, damn,
she was
crazy.
One of the friends.
she's one of the friends of the girl getting her car pimped.
That show was terrible, to be honest.
Really?
I mean, it was enjoyable.
In hindsight,
no, don't get me wrong,
it's like, a terrible
it was a
show.
Fun show to watch,
yeah,
but it's a terrible
show. About to pimp your ride,
yeah, it was
the boy Exhibit.
Everything bro, I said was crazy.
I will call him for you.
What's that?
2022.
Do it.
You might need your ride pill.
You might need your ride pill. 100%.
But it's like, I be feeling like that. Why y'all about this dude to do car?
He likes poker, so we put a poker table in the back.
Like, yo, you know you can't. He gonna need more people to play.
He gonna need more people to play.
Sit here and play poker by himself. A lot of that shit was just fucking silly. Yeah, I remember they put a fucking chandelier in somebody's car. Yo, what the fuck? Hey, this is a safety.
It's a fucking shag wagon. What this we doing?
Yeah. It's fucking like, there's like shaggy carpet all over the car or something. Like, yo, why the fuck are they doing this? And it was all about the fucking, the speaker system and shit like that.
Yeah.
That's what
that was the really prize in the rims.
Right. And the rims. Yeah. Look at these wheels right here. What kind of, you know, rims are we going to put on this?
35 inch rims. On your Volkswagen Bug.
Yeah. I did see that though. I thought that was pretty interesting, but I feel like, you know, some of that shit I knew was kind of fake anyway.
I hoped that show was fake.
I think it's fucked up for some of those people. Probably. And they say it took like months for them to get their car back.
I'm sure.
Like several months.
I seen this. I don't know if y'all seen this funny clip from Gooden. I'm not Gooden. Boozer. Call us Boozer.
And my real track.
I thought it was a funny clip. A wild clip.
18,000 square feet. I returned you, so I'm coming here for a season. And my realtor in LA kept hitting me up saying someone wants to rent your house. I was like, no, I need to spend no time in my house. He's willing to pay $95,000 a month. And I was like, oh. I didn't know who it was until he got the car.
$95,000?
He was like, yeah. Shit. He went to the crib, so that was all good. I like tore my hamstring like four or five times. It's a really good
Prince ran in his crib.
LA named Judy Cito, so I went out to LA to see her. I kept calling Prince. I'm going to stop by the house, but he wasn't returning my call. I pulled up to the house. I had these two golden lions on the gate, and it wasn't there. It was this symbol that I had never seen before. Whose house is this? And he literally had ripped out every single thing in my house. Everything was purple and black everywhere. Let me turn the weight room into a nightclub with a disco ball, DJ booth, had a massage parlor in one room. I finally get a hold of him, and he's in Asia doing a tour for his album. He's like, Boots, don't worry, I got you. He wired me $500,000 to ease my mind. He was like, when I move out, it'll be like I was never there. Long story short, he rents my crib out for a year, redecorated the entire house. Then wires me $500,000. And then when I got there at the end of his lease, it was like he was never there. That's how much money Prince had.
I thought it was a pretty nuts story.
That's crazy. Tell him to leave everything. Leave it how you got it.
Leave it how you got it.
Yeah. Don't make it to where you were like you were never here. Just leave the house exactly how you renovated it.
He said he renovated this whole crib. So it would suit him. He had like a little club. He turned his weight room into a club. It's some wild shit.
I mean, shit, $95,000 a month. That's
why is somebody firing, you know, $500,000? Yeah, I got you. Don't worry about it.
Give you a peace of mind. Here's $500,000.
My bad for the, you know. I didn't tell you I was doing all that. Here go happen.
It's all good thing.
Yeah.
That is wild.
Money fixes problems. I don't know what people out there talk about.
Hey.
Where did you see that?
It was just randomly on IG. He was just telling the story. I thought it was kind of random. But also interesting. Shout out to Prince, RIP.
That's legendary.
Definitely.
Right there.
T-Mac was making his way around a few shows I listened to. He's got a one-on-one basketball league he's trying to get promoted.
That's dope.
Yeah, it sounded pretty cool the way they were setting it up and stuff. And he was talking about finding out Vince Carter was his cousin. Did y'all hear any of that story?
I did hear about that story.
No,
that's being his cousin.
He had gone to North Carolina to play ball. I think he was at a prep school or something. And he would go practice with UNC sometimes, like off-season or whatever. So he knew Vince and all those guys, and he said, like, I got to go to a family reunion. I'm going to be gone this weekend. And he sits down like Vince's grandma or something, and they find out they're cousins. He's like, hey, yo, this is T-Mac. I'm your cousin. And then from then on, obviously, they became closer, and then Vince was looking out for him, like, with the Raptors, that kind of thing. It was cool. T-Mac used to be one of my favorites.
Yeah,
and he was a cool dude to listen to.
But. So what's the idea with the 101 league? Is it for, like, it's not going to be like the big three where it's like these old ass players, or is it going to be like fresh?
I think he mentioned that there's like YouTube leagues that are set up already doing one-on-one stuff. So he wants to get involved with them and get some of those like street ball type of guys. I believe he mentioned that there were some like maybe younger guys that didn't make it in the NBA. Right. I want to say it was like Glenn Robinson's son was somebody that he mentioned that's playing in the league. Stuff like that. So I don't know. It sounds like it's younger people.
Right.
That but makes it was sense. Like more of like a game to seven.
I probably would
one-on-one.
To see that.
Yeah.
It sounded cool. Like you would want to see younger players play one-on-one.
Yeah.
Because old heads is going to back each other down the whole time. Yeah.
I watch some one-on-one stuff on YouTube. I like a lot of the street ball stuff that they've got on there. So they kind of have a setup that they do with the one-on-one.
Like a drill.
You can only dribble a certain amount of times.
Two or three dribbles.
Yeah.
You got to score.
So I'm sure it's something like that. But I think it's a cool idea for like some off-season stuff.
Yeah.
Like obviously not during the NBA season at all. But I don't know. Hopefully it takes off. Sounds cool.
Is the big three over with?
I haven't heard anything about it like in years.
Yeah.
Seems like it's been multiple
years. I think after... COVID
just wiped them out. Huh?
Yeah. It took them out for sure.
But I don't know. Those kind of leagues are like ones that you don't hear about until they're about to, until they're gone. It's like, Big Three is on Saturdays.
Right.
Who knows?
Interesting. Yeah, damn, I was just thinking about something that slipped my mind. Fuck.
I don't have shit. Girls.
I don't either, man. I have nothing else written down.
Oh, y'all see Cole back playing semi-pro again?
I did see that. What league
playing the pro league in Canada?
Yeah,
I think it's Drake's team, which makes it kind of.
I heard something about that.
Is he just as bad, or is he better?
I mean, he scored 3 points his first game.
So he's just as bad. He's
just as bad. I mean,
take that shit to the Y.
Take it to the Y. I don't think they would be putting him on his teams if he wasn't decent. No, I think he got a nice jumper.
He's J. Cole.
He got a nice jumper.
He's J. Cole. That's why he's making.
Sure, they might have some influence, of course.
Right.
I don't think any rapper could just say, "Oh, because I'm a rapper, you're gonna put me on the team."
It's the fucking.
How many fans could they really have there? It's a draw right there.
What? No, in Canada, you don't think Cole probably got a shit ton of fans in Canada.
No, I'm saying like these leagues can't have much of a fan base.
Right.
So
right.
If you could get somebody named J. Cole to be on your team.
That's what it's about.
I think so. That's cool. It's cool that he's pursuing basketball. I don't actually care. But it is interesting that like multiple teams now. Yeah. It kind of seems
he wants this shit. Yeah, he wants this shit. Hey, do what you gotta do, man.
Give it up, dog.
Keep chasing your dreams, bro. As long as the doors keep opening, why not? Why not?
I'm not a supporter of it.
Why are you hating?
I'm not hating. I mean, he can play. It's okay for me to say that he's not good. that's not hating.
I'm okay with that. I don't care either way.
Yeah. I mean, I'm fine.
Got a nice little J.
When he just opens himself up for that. Like, you don't actually deserve this spot because you're not very good.
Yeah. I ain't got no problem with it.
It's not like
they made him the starter and you the star player of the team. He coming off the bench, like second off the bench type shit.
I mean,
ain't nothing crazy.
If he's fine with, I guess if he's fine with living his life that way.
I'm sure he is.
Okay.
Like, why wouldn't he be very comfortable?
I don't think nobody's forcing him to do these things.
Possibly. Never know.
All right, well, we told y'all early on it was a light week. Wasn't a whole lot to happen, so we'd be a little bit short this week, but we'll be back next week. We got samples coming still. If you're on the audio, stay tuned. If you're on YouTube, we'll be back next week. Peace.
That's a fact. This thing, LaMelo.
That's a fact. I do like that commercial.
Yeah, it's funny.
All right, I got mine ready. I don't know if we've used this before. This is by Mr. Twin Sister called Meet the Frownies.
The Frownies. I think I know this.
This is Kanye.
That sounds like last night. No, I couldn't answer. What's that Diddy shit? Was that Dirty Money?
I'll have to check.
If I told you once, I told you. Oh, I know what that is. That's fuck.
This is a good one.
Is that Cole?
What's the sample part?
Huh? This what? Part.
I don't know. I'm not sure.
I'll come back on it again.
Recent.
Not super recent, probably.
Isn't that Cole?
10, 15 years ago. Nah.
Shit, I know this fucking sample, bro. Hold on, give me a second.
It's so close, on the tip of his tongue.
It is, bro. I know this fucking song.
I have no clue.
Oh, man. Hold on. Give me one more second. I'm so mad because I know this fucking song. I can't get it.
All right, ready?
Boss or something on, though.
Kendrick Lamar featuring Dr. Dre, The Recipe.
Kendrick. I don't know why I didn't say Kendrick. That's a good one. I knew that song.
Good Kid, Mad City.
Yeah.
That's fire. Dre was getting his on there, too.
I wonder who wrote his verse.
I'll probably say Kendrick.
Probably so.
I would think.
Probably so.
I thought that was a good one.
That was. It was solid.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
What you got, Carl?
This is Tomoya Otani.
Hmm.
His World is actually from the...
Oh, yeah. It's more, yeah.
It's from the Sonic the Hedgehog original soundtrack, the video game.
The video game.
Yeah.
Why are you vibing like that to the violins?
It's actually pretty dope.
It is. That sounds familiar, too.
This song came out in 2017.
Is this a song?
No.
Oh, it's a sample.
I'm not really close, but it sounds super familiar.
Yeah. Sounds like something that somebody would use.
I don't know.
So it's Drake.
Okay.
Off of More Life. KMT. And it's funny that we were talking
about... Here I am, and I'm in.
Yeah, it's funny that we were talking about X, because this is the reason why they were beefing.
They brought that really? Up in the doc.
Said he Drake stole his flow, which he did.
He did.
From the Look At Me.
Yeah, genre. From the Look At Me record. Look at me. Look at me. He really did, though. That's fine.
It's the same flow.
That's good, yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Demon just got out of the can. I gave my bro an event. Love is just not in my plan. Not even taking a check. Studio right in my yacht. I'm doing 10 in a week.
Mm-hmm.
How long I've been on the street?
That's fire.
Good choice.
All right. Well, my sample comes from I got two. Jay-Z, Emil, and Beanie Siegel. Do it again.
Rockefeller. Y'all know what this is. They're giving y'all 5 seconds to put your drink down and report to the dance floor immediately. All the bosses, we're giving y'all five seconds
to get to the exit.
It's about to get real ugly in here.
5 seconds is up. Let's go. A little volume. A little volume.
Somebody sampled this recently.
Yeah.
How recent?
Is it Tyrese?
I said how recent.
Oh. I was like, fucking Tyrese. Friday.
Jim Jones.
Yeah.
I may know.
Yeah. It's pretty easy to pick that one. It did not, a lot of these first from the early 2000s though on there. Hard. Thought this one was pretty dope. Off the Leash.
Fuck these niggas talk about what happened in the verses. We back to back in a row, trucks, they look like hearses. Thought it wasn't churches, I got a chicken in a snack box. A trunk in the front while I be dipping through the back box. Some skeletons in my closet is the watches I got. Ow, shit, I could have bought a house with this watch that I got. You catch us running up in all the popular spots, bitch. If it's up, then it's out, we start popping them shots. I got a couple shooters, they gon' drill for me. They old couple, one ain't gon' kill for free. Still bang the beans until I say so.
And the young motherfuckers is telling me.
You know the worst 250 caught a million in the V. That's at least 500 what I'm willing to V. I forgot about the chain, that's a million in the V. And this bitch lost her mind, she start feeling the G. Fuck her. 12 a.m. we was at the lobby. 1 a.m. we pulled up to the party. 3 a.m. we jumped back in the rocket.
I gotta hear some Mano raps. You think he can't rap?
Yeah, all right, I gotta hear it. Is this real?
Yes.
12 a.m. we in the lobby again. We got the little squad on the leash. From the lobby, now we back to the streets. No Ferrari.
This Mano?
That's not him doing that.
Oh, what's going on? The
world with a couple niggas that I once loved. The streets took my heart, baby, I don't know how to love. Self-made, yeah, nigga, got it out the mud. Took a few strippers on that I met up in the club. Give them what they want, player, go player. I just fucked the baby mama of a ball player. Look at how they treat the boy, I'm there. Shorty in the passion side.
Top tier, huh?
I hate him.
Look at how this shit on his legs. Y'all should've seen us in the club last night. We just made a mess in the club last night. Had her and a friend in a truck last night.
Got it. Shout out to Mano and Jim Jones.
My opinion about Mano, good song. My opinion about Mano won't change.
I understand.
What not?
I feel like didn't he got expect
his.
It to. I feel
like
at
he
all.
Got his. Nah, of course not.
Based off of that.
Of course not. Just had to actually let you hear a Mano verse.
Now you can know. Check it off your box.
So Mano.
Oh, God. How do we deal with this guy? Any other words
sick.
Of wisdom, fellas?
Words of wisdom. Damn, I even looked up no words of wisdom in a minute.
I don't have a lot of wisdom.
I've been listening to Corey Holcomb. He said,
okay, here we go.
Once you start giving effort, you just open yourself up for disappointment.
Damn. That's some pessimistic thinking,
yeah,
right there.
Yeah, positive, no?
Don't try that shit you're thinking about. Just leave that shit alone, bro.
Just quit. Quit while you're ahead.
Like, oh, you actually tried? That's fucking insane.
You're a fucking loser.